all set to go here then in our first Malaysian Grand Prix in 3 years, and we are underway in Moto3. Superb launch in the middle of that front row by the world champion Ethan Guevara, absolutely flying down towards a long drag to the first corner. There was contact there further back. I don't know if that was Yamanaka maybe, I'm not sure who was involved, but Foggia in second, Garcia third, but a lightning start from Guevara.
Yeah, Yamanaka I think is on the outside there, he just got eased wide by Ivan Ortola. Some contact there through turn one, of course contact on the run down to turn one. One or two of those grid slots, particularly under the grandstand here on the left hand side of the racetrack, were probably still on some damp racetrack that might have affected Foggia off the line.
Now they're already through the first sector. Guevara had an advantage of nearly 0.4 seconds. That's been swallowed up as his teammate Sergio Garcia does make it a gas 1-2 on the first half of this Malaysian Grand Prix. That's what they want in the championship come the final reckoning in Valencia in 2 weeks' time. Now can Guevara immediately find a way through, or Garcia rather, on his team? And here comes the Rocky though. That's a late lunge from Foggia into turn nine, and he has made it through.
Pick a line, any line. They were going 3-4 abreast through there. Stefano Nepra is the next rider along in fifth position as the Aspar teammates go side by side. Nepra now at the inside of Suzuki to take fourth. He's got plenty of confidence on this first lap of the Grand Prix. Not so for Yumi Sasaki though. He's down four places. He's outside the top 10 now.
Brilliant start by Ethan Guevara. There was clearly some contact then. It was Mino and Holgado. Oh, that was really scary. Look how close Mino went to the inside wall there. He clearly had to back out of it as there was contact with one of our Rookie of the Year contenders. We're looking back now then towards the 96 and 16. Holgado squeezed in between his teammate Masia and Mino. Ooh, elbow to elbow, scary as they went through the gears on that long run to the first corner.
So as the moment goes, it's Sergio Garcia who leads it, of course. He's in pole position for the runner-up spot in the championship. His nearest challenger, Foggia, is next along in second. Then it's Masia and Munoz. Diogo Moreira has also got away. Oh, big moment! That's Nepa down. The riders doing everything they can to avoid it.
That's a scary, scary incident there. Horrible, scary incident. Nepa, where he had the big scare at the end of the first lap into turn number 15. And he's asked too much of that Dunlop rear tyre on the power out of turn nine. Big, big high side. Nepa then, there'll be no third consecutive top six finish for him.
We're on board with Sergio Garcia looking at the sister Red Bull IRKTM of Jaume Masia. Moreira there showing a front wheel. This is one of the many hard braking zones where you can really send one up the inside.
Oh, Munoz has gone down. Well, it's almost a carbon copy, a little bit further up the road of the Nepa high side. Tricky conditions here, not a lot of grip around. It would have been washed away overnight by the heavy rain, and that's a massive blow for Munoz's hopes of being crowned Rookie of the Year. Thankfully, he's quickly on his feet, but there's another rider.
Suzuki's gone down as well.
So turn nine has caught out. That's on the entry to turn nine, isn't it, for Suzuki? So turn nine has taken out some of the big hitters, the big players in this Malaysian Grand Prix. We lost Nepa out of the top six very early on. Now we've lost Munoz out of podium contention. Here he is, and in fourth place, he's going to light up that rear tyre. Was he just a little bit offline, maybe on a slightly tighter inside line there? But Munoz loses the rear, and he is out of this Sepang Grand Prix when sitting in a very strong fourth place. Big old whack there on his left shoulder, his left hip. That was a bone cruncher for Munoz.
Now it'll be Suzuki going down. He lost the front on the way in to turn nine. That will be, he's rejoined the race, but that'll be a fourth consecutive race now for Tatsuki Suzuki that he has failed to score, as Moreira now attacks Garcia once again. Moreira up into second place, a huge opportunity for him now, and Holgado, of course, with Munoz out of the Grand Prix in that battle for Rookie of the Year.
Back into podium contention. We're looking back there as Ayuma Sasaki again makes another move in these fast corners. The Husqvarna is just handling superbly at the moment around this Sepang circuit. Don't know, well, I would imagine that Sasaki's not really using up too much of that rear tyre to get himself through.
He's under pressure there.
Guevara picks off two, Masia and Sasaki into turn nine. The move of a world champion by the new world champion.
Yeah, world champion at work. Ethan Guevara just cruising through the field as Garcia once again gets his nose off. He likes to take that tight line at a few places around this racetrack, which could land him in trouble if he sticks his nose in somewhere where it's going to get chopped off. Garcia then holds on to fifth at the moment, but you can see Guevara's progress from a pretty poor opening stages when, of course, he had to dodge Nepa. He certainly made up for lost time. He was right on the rear wheel now of Foggia.
We've now got a lead group of 10 because McPhee and Rossi have come to play at the front of this Grand Prix. Not too far behind Artigas. Well, Rossi is Artigas and Ongio as well. They may well get themselves back into contention as well. well. We're still over half of this Malaysian Grand Prix to run. Garcia on the inside of both Sasaki and Masia into turn number 15. Superb late breaking manoeuvre there by the man trying to hold on to second place in the World Championship. There are your top 10 riders then coming over the line now, with Anju and Artiga trying to get themselves back into contention. Foggia leads. Can Guevara pick up some slipstream on the gas machine? No, he can't. Sasaki will hold third place into turn one.
Oh, almost contact there between Holgado and Garcia. The two gas riders don't lack any confidence on the brakes, but Garcia was on the outside there, couldn't turn in into turn one, and very nearly got hit from behind by Danny Holgado as this leading group telescopes together. As Matt says, it's a leading group of 10. They're back in the 2:14 still, so it won't be too long at this pace before Anju and Artigas are on them.
Yeah, Ricardo Rossi's the quickest man in the league group, as Guevara then does hit the front. He's back at the front. He made the dream launch from the middle of that front row at the start of the Grand Prix. He was nearly 4/10 clear in that first sector on lap one before he started to drop back through the field. But as he so often does, he's clawed his way back into contention, picked his way through some of the best riders in the Moto3 World Championship. And now, on lap number 9, the world champion back in the position where he loves to be, P1.
And Sasaki picks off Foggia, as we saw back in Motegi. Ethan Guevara so good through the faster corners. It enables him to pull out a couple of bike lengths over the chasing group behind him. Alberto Surra is out of the Grand Prix, so a pretty poor afternoon for the Snipers team. Minho's dropped down to 15th, of course, after that delay on the rundown to turn one, and his teammate Surra is out of the Grand Prix.
6.5 laps to go, and who's in P6? Yes, you guessed it. Diogo Moreira once again on the MTA helmets machine. Now then, can Garcia use his brilliance on the braking into the final corner to take Foggia? No, he can't, but Foggia loses the lead. Brilliantly done there by Guevara on the brakes of that gas Aspar machine. So Guevara will be back at the front as we complete lap number 11. There'll be 6 to go here in this penultimate Grand Prix of the season, the Petronas Grand Prix of Malaysia. So much at stake in terms of second place in the World Championship. Foggia, is he going to have the... Well, he'll be on the outside. He's going to be hung out to dry here as well, because Garcia will pinch the inside line through the first corner. Will Foggia be able to immediately strike back into the sweep through turn two? No, he can't. So it's again a gas 1-2 here in Sepang. Now then, Garcia's been really, really good on the brakes going to turn 9. Is he going to try and fire that gas machine on the inside of his teammate Guevara? I don't think he's going to be quite close enough. Guevara just too good on the brakes. In fact, Garcia was all out of shape there, wasn't he? And that's allowed Foggia through. It's going to allow Sasaki through as well. On the outside goes Sasaki. That was a costly error on the brakes by Garcia. He's been so good into 9. And as good as Garcia has been into 9, how good has Sasaki been into 11? Brilliant helicopter shot picks him up there on the inside of Foggia. Sasaki second.
Well, Foggia and Sasaki were having their own battle, and all of a sudden they caught up with Garcia, who was wide into turn 9. Garcia's lost another one now as Jaume Masia goes through. So a rhythm of messy, scruffy 12th lap of this Grand Prix for Sergio Garcia. He's going to need that late braking into turn 15. He's playing some catch up now in fifth. He's got Diogo Moreira and Ricardo Rossi now queuing up behind him.
Just at the top of your pitch, Joel, the middle of your pitch now, you can see Artigas and Ortola and Yamanaka. There, that's full. Artigas is 12th, Yamanaka 13th.
2-1 for Garcia.
Garcia has been so lethal, hasn't he, on the brakes in a turn 15. That's where there's going to be fireworks from the Spanish rider on the last lap if he's in contention. So then, there are now 5 laps to go here in Malaysia. The world champion, Ethan Guevara, still doing high 2:13s. Slightly quicker behind him on the 71 bike was Ima Sasaki. Masia reclaims third place on the brakes on the inside of Garcia. Oh, there was contact. I think that was contact between Moreira and Rossi. We'll have to try and see that one from the sort of trackside cameras, but it did look like there might have been a little nudge there from Moreira on the inside of Rossi. Rossi down though at turn one, and Sasaki just breezes on by Guevara. Garcia again. Masia, his latest victim on the brakes into turn number 15, and Garcia once again moves back.
Garcia!
That's scary! Look, it's Guevara, Ethan Guevara somehow keeps control of that gas machine. He was on the wet grass. Wow, that was really, really scary. Heart in the mouth moment there for Ethan Guevara, the new world champion. Over the line, he came in 9th place, having led out of that final corner.
Yeah, he was heading towards the pit wall at one stage there. It cost him 3 seconds with that move. Here's a look at it on the way out of the final corner. He's up behind Sasaki. He makes contact with the back of Sasaki, who then also has to run off the track. And somehow, Guevara wrestles back control before he heads into the pit wall.
Did Sasaki maybe miss a gear or something there coming out of that final corner? Because Guevara just ran into the back of him. It looked like Sasaki had just lost momentum coming out of that turn number 15. 15, and Guevara just had nowhere to go. That was really, really scary then for the world champion. That looks like it's ruined his hopes of a third victory in the last four Grand Prix then for Guevara. He did slip back down. Well, he's now in 10th place because Yamanaka's got on through as he tries to regain his composure.
Yeah, I wonder whether he might have damaged something on that gas because he's lost a further 2 seconds in the first sector of this lap. He came across the line in 9th, 2.9 I believe. Of course, he would have been going down that start-finish rate much slower than he should have been as well. So that will have cost him a lot of time. He'll just be in the back of your picture. So his victory hopes have gone. And for the Aspar team, it all now rests on Sergio Garcia, and he's doing a pretty good job as he regains the lead from Jaume Massia. And Garcia now back in pole position in this chase for the runner-up spot. He has Massia between himself and Foggia, with McPhee now in the middle of this leading group out of nowhere. He's up to fourth.
John McPhee, having come from 22nd on the grid at the start of this Grand Prix, up into podium contention. There's late lunges here coming from Massia and Foggia. Foggia gets through on Massia and Sasaki. Three abreast on the exit of that final corner. And we're entering the final lap now, and it's Sergio Garcia that will lead it. Foggia by a whisker will hold up the second place. They are now three abreast over the line. McPhee trying to pick up some slipstream as well. But Garcia leads on this final lap here in Sepang.
They're too busy squabbling over who's going to be second. They're letting Garcia away with this as Foggia trying to launch his attack with that double overtake into turn 15. He does now take second place. Foggia's got the advantage of the straight line speed on that Leopard Honda. Can he get close enough into any of those braking zones, and can he possibly outbrake Garcia?
Nice move there by Sasaki, firing that Husky on the inside of Massia into turn number two.
Foggia will be a brave move from there, but he's going for it.
Garcia was almost kissing the white line on the inside there on that sweep out of turn number eight, and Foggia now has the inside line. Is the Rocket timing this to absolute perfection? He's out well wide there, running a real wide line, wasn't he, coming out of turn 10 and then through 11, side by side, Foggia and Garcia lean on each other, and now Massia hits the front, down there into turn 12 and 13, Foggia's on the paintwork, so is Garcia. Oh. You cannot take your eyes off this, they're almost five abreast into turn 15, and out of nowhere, John McPhee comes from fifth to first. It's going to be a final corner showdown here in Sepang.
Well, Foggia's in a position he'd want to be. It's a five-rider battle. It's a six-rider battle. Moreira's still in there as well, as Sasaki tries to head off his own teammate. Sasaki up the inside now.
Sasaki on the inside of John McPhee. Sergio Garcia's good on the brakes in the turn 15, but not that good. McPhee pitches the inside line, and has he taken the victory here in Malaysia? It's going to be all about the run to the finish line. John McPhee on course for an incredible victory. McPhee will take it. The flying Scotsman wins another sensational race in Sepang. John McPhee started that 17 lap Petronas Grand Prix of Malaysia down in 22nd place. And after such a difficult 2022, you can't keep a good man down for long, can you? John McPhee produces some magic in Malaysia. There's his fiancée Lauren getting swallowed up in the celebrations for the Stellar Ghana Husqvarna Max Racing team.